run to NIAID?
We're just calling her Laura now.
Good. Thank goodness for that. How is she eating?
Fine.
Good. Pooping?
Like clockwork.
Finrot come back?
Not since the medicine you gave us.
All right, little Arunda. Sorry, Laura. Let's get you on the scale.
Go!
Rhea, I thought about what you said. And you were right. Will you meet me at the church? Right now?
Mommy, are you awake? Hey, Mommy.
I'm your man. My grease back hair and burns can do the talking. What the hell you gonna do to me? My motorcycle boots can kick your teeth in. When I'm done, it's gonna hurt for you to pee. Giddy up!
And you say riding heat is for the loser.
Yeah!
And you say riding lightning's got the bite.
Son, it sure feels alright. Poor girl may be tall and tan and giggly. She's got long legs, yeah, so what? My girl's good and pale and hot and feisty. Hell, my rockabilly shit could kick your butt. Giddy up!
And you say riding heat is for the loser.
Woo!
And you say riding lightning's got the bite.
Here we go!
But if you ride the heat with the devil at your feet,
my God, son, it sure feels all right. Woo! It sure feels all right. Oh!
That baby's stepping on our turf. Weren't we going to be the ones to talk about that stuff?
I think that train is already out of the station.
Okay, y'all, that's our show. If you liked it, please tell your friends, and don't forget to tag me on Instagram. If I like your picture enough, I'll repost it, and then my followers...
My Texas tape ring on my wall is right here. Let go of
my arm. My mom's missing too.
I'm calling the police.
No, I will. Where's my phone?
All right. What's the deal here? Let us handle this. We're off duty.
Off duty what?
Hey, they stole our stuff.
Yeah, check her diaper.
I'm sure there's been a misunderstanding. Like, did y'all look over there in the rocks?
See, just must have just fallen out of your tower.
I don't know what y'all are up to here. We don't like it.
Just get your stuff. Those mermaid hustlers are long gone.
Yeah, they're probably off trying to scam some tourists. What duty did you say you're off?
to my soul. We all shoot the thrill, and we all play to kill. You ask me, who's in control? That's me, let's go. I got a file in my pocket like the file in my soul. I'm already the rock, and I'm already the roll. I got a fire in my pocket like the fire in my soul. I'm already the rock. And I'm ready to roll.
Stupid. Several instruments separate from the pieces. Should be illegal. Eliza Spring, where the heck are you?
Hey, Fred Harrison.
It's me, Fred. Fred Harrison. Casey Harrison's dad? Big trombone in school?
Yes, I know you, Mr. Harrison. We met when Casey and I were in seventh grade, and you've reintroduced yourself to me pretty much every single time we've seen each other.
For the past 20 years, it's good to see you, but...
Really, Don. Darling, it's so good to see you. It's me, Fred. Fred Harrison. Casey Harrison's dada.
Actually, we're just calling her Laura now.
Dang y'all fast.
Is this your dad?
You followed us?
Well,
what a beautiful comb. Get this from the pawn shop? I saw one exactly like this in there.
No, but actually, I was just on my way there to try and buy that one you saw. I'd like to get a matching set for Laura.
Wow, you get that much money from mermaiding? That thing had a price tag on it for 25 grand.
25 grand?
Just yesterday it was 250. What happened?
Well, the guy at the pawn shop did say an appraiser had come in. I guess he saw it and knew it was too cheap. But wow, 25 grand for a hair comb?
A hair comb just like this one? Hey!
Hair must, especially by strangers.
How rude not to introduce ourselves. I'm Byron, and this is Marlon.
No, Laura's daddy gave this comb to her.
Oh, we're new fans of Eliza's work.
Actually, I hear he's coming into town next week for the festival, in case y'all want to jam.
Oh, wow. Olokan and his band? I'd like to see them again, but I've got to have a lot more practice before I can play in their horn. Do you play anymore?
I've been concentrating more on my mermaid work, but I'd love to get back into it. I didn't even know you played.
I didn't even have a horn until today. Here's the kicker. It was free.
It was free?
Free-ish. I do have to trade him a big bucket of pecans every week for the wrangling. I've ordered it for some guns.
Guns?
Oh yeah, lots and lots of guns. Let me explain. Just this year, the church made me an elder. Besides cleaning the gutters and handing out programs, another one of the elder duties is estate dispersal.
What is that?
Our congregation has a lot of folks in their 90s and up. A lot of them are near the end of their lives. They want to downsize and disperse out their estates and possessions. And nobody possesses more firearms than a God-fearing Texan Presbyterian on death's door.
So the church just gives you all their guns?
Every Tuesday this year, right at high noon. I don't like to keep them though. It makes my wife nervous. I trade them at the pawn shop. Four instruments, mostly flutes and string instruments until today. We play them on Sunday at the church during services.
Wow, that's so nice of you.
I get to keep the instruments. It's really not that nice of me. But it is nice to have a weekly routine. Usually, the guns are crap. I couldn't even get a case for today's haul. My elder pal is Cedric, and he's the unofficial firearm gatherer. He told me that next week he's expecting a real beauty. One of the estates is giving him the pair of Colt 45s that Willie carried on the Honeysuckle Rose. Cedric says that pair is worth $50,000.
$50,000?
I'll be able to get a whole marching band worth of instruments with cases for that. Ah, shoot. I gotta get that. Linda cooked up that snapper that we caught on our fishing trip last week. Aw, don't try to leave me. Maybe your mommy will take you fishing someday, too.
Don't. It's okay. We're still vegetarian. She's a little sensitive.
Oh, yes. I remember now. Right. Sorry. Goodbye, Eliza. Goodbye, Larunda. I mean, Laura the lake trout. Nice to meet you, Laura. Bye.
Yes. You too. We'll see each other again soon. I'm sure of it.
Next week, probably. Hey, mermaid. Where are you going? You owe us.
Owe you?
Have you already forgotten Angry Bob we saved you from an hour ago?
Huh?
You know, life's a funny thing. Here I was chasing you down because I wanted to get a pretty girl's number. But damned if we didn't stumble right into an opportunity. For all three of us.
What's that?
You want something, and so do we.
What I want is none of your concern.
Well, it became my concern when we saw you today. We don't like to see a local performance artist like you, much less a single mother artist, reduce the crime and make ends meet.
And maybe I'm a little smitten by your tail.
Ugh, Merbert.
Listen, we want the same thing.
How's that? You want a pretty hair comb too?
No, but we all basically want the same things. Money, comfort, love, better life for our loved ones.
Huh.
All I'm proposing is this. Have that comb. All you have to do is you help us get Willie Nelson's Colts. Your friend's dad. We'll take half for us, and we'll get 25 for whatever dumb hair
accessory you want. Deal?
No deal.
Yes, deal.
I don't think.
Listen, Eliza Spring, I like you and your daughter. Larunda Nyad, right? We won't hurt you, but we will get those guns. Faith Presbyterian, was it? Next Tuesday? High noon?
Help us and no one gets hurt, and you'll get your prize. Don't help us, and I'll still get my prize, but someone will definitely be hurt.
See you next Tuesday, last spring.
Like I said, Mervert.
my mermaid baby.
Don't call her that.
That's what she is, right?
No. I mean, yes, but don't call her that. I want her to feel normal.
But she isn't normal. She's better. How do you make her run out of thing all the time?
Shh. Keep your voice down. I just got her under. And for the record, I don't make her wear the comb all the time. Just when we go out. I don't want her to feel like, I don't know, unnormal. I need to talk to you.
Ooh, you got a boy?
I mean, sort of. Remember Casey Harrison?
Yes, of course. The three of us made up the entire trombone section.
Her dad today, you remember Fred?
Ew, he's married! In like 40.
No, gross. No, I mean, I saw him, but the guys I met are not him. I think Fred's in some kind of trouble.
Fred is trouble. Didn't you say you think he knows about Laura?
I said I don't think he knows. I trust Laura's doctor. We've known her like 20 years. Anyway, these guys I met, next Tuesday they want me to do something bad. But I think it would be for something good. You know, for Laura.
What?
They want me to help them steal a pair of guns from Fred. They're worth like $50,000, and they'll give me half if I help.
$25,000? What would you do with it?
You know how that comb that Olacon gave to Laura before he left is magic? How it lets her walk with human legs when she wears it?
Duh.
Well, Ola told me that this comb that Laura wears has a twin. An identical twin, but the other comb has a curse.
A curse?
Yeah, a curse. But he said that this curse would only come out when the two twin combs are together. So he promised to hide the other comb.
I bet he lost it.
Yeah, he told me he did. But I guess his set at ACL that year didn't pay as much as he thought it would. So before he swam back to rule the Nigerian Sea, he pawned it.
I thought y'all don't talk anymore.
So, a few months ago, Olacon's mom moved into Lady Bird Lake to be closer to her grandbaby and help babysit every once in a while. And we were talking, and she told me about him pawning the second comb. And she also finally told me what the curse is.
So, what is the curse?
I mean, it doesn't seem like a curse at all. It's a blessing.
How so?
When the naiads wear just one of the combs, human lion legs for a little while. But when they wear both combs in their hair at the same time, they lose their tail.
So?
So, with that other comb, I could cure Laura.
Cure her?
Yeah, cure her. Please, do not start this again.
But I keep telling you, she isn't sick. She's perfect. Her mom is a mermaid and her dad is a real rock god. Literally, her dad is God.
He is not God. He is a god. And I'm technically not a real mermaid. Also, it's not rock. It's more like some lucid dream funk.
Whatever. You are a real good mom. And she is still, like, basically a miniature Princess Mer-Jesus. If you take away her tail, aren't you taking away her gift?
Maybe. But I just want a normal life for my daughter. I really want to do what's best for her.
I know you do, but you know, you never really have been interested in a normal life. If you truly want what is best for your daughter, you have to stop hustling and stealing and considering unjust performing. And you know I have your back, right?
Yeah, I know.
So you know I'll help you, however you need. But you need to make sure you're doing this for Laura, not for you. Stop playing. That's too loud anyway. It's time to go to church to get your guns. I'm coming with you so we can go to Alamo South with Cedric and Andrea afterwards.
Oh, shoot. I didn't think Dr. Harrison would be here.
Casey's mom is a pediatrician. Oh, okay. Then Fred definitely knows.
I told you, I trust Laura's doctor. Shh.
Maybe the guys won't remember which church.
Oh, crap.
Should we go now?
No, let's give them a chance to...
Wait.
Marlon, stop. Byron, no. What are y'all doing?
Mermaid came to our date.
Where's your thief daughter?
Eliza. Eliza Spring? It's me, Fred Harrison. Casey Harrison's dad.
I know who you are, Fred.
I don't know who any of you are. Boys, I've got a lot of nerve. Busting up on us like this.
Save it. Just give us Willie's Colt so no one gets hurt.
Feel your hands, you sons of bitches.
Whoa!
Damn, Mr. Cogburn, now I really am going to have to hurt somebody.
Holy hell! Nothing heavy.
Rhea!
Rhea! Rhea Tissy? It's me, Fred Harrison. Casey Harrison's dad.
We know who you are, Fred.
To take them into the sheriff?
Nah, I don't want to miss our movie. Alamo won't let you in late.
Yeah, let's take them into the church.
They can help with the elder duties.
But they just tried to kill you.
Lots of things tried to kill me. But I figured we already all got our reason, or we're in need of a reason. These young men still need their reason. I bet they'll find it. At the bottom of all these church gutters that need cleaning.
Pastor won't like that. Nah, I bet he will. Oh, before I forget, here's a Coke. These John Wayne wannabe wanted. I'm gonna get him out of here to my police suckers. Okay, let's go. Oh, wait till you see what I got next week. I got some real beauties coming in.
Hold up, you need five. Maybe motorcycle needs my soul.
swim.